Hey everyone, this is Joe from Atelier Switchup. In this video, I'll show you how I installed my new router table and router table accessories. Stay tuned. For my new router table, I went with the Harvey RT685. I had a Rockler standalone, which worked okay, but wanted to free up floor space. Here's everything that's inside the package. Feel free to pause and screenshot the measurements to check if it fits your table saw. Make sure your table saw is unplugged before starting disassembly. Here, I'm using my Rockwell stand to help with the install. Speaking of Rockwell stand, I'll link all products I'm using in the description below, in case you're interested in purchasing. Use the supplied hardware to fasten the router table to your table saw. Don't forget to use the leg extensions if your table sits high due to the mobile base. If you have some parallel clamps, you can flip them and use them to level your table before tightening the bolts. After leveling the table and tightening the fasteners, I reinstalled the rail for my table saw's fence and moved the table back. I'm installing this router plate from Old School without the router, so I can easily adjust the height and make sure it's perfectly leveled. I decided to go with a Triton TRA001 so I didn't have to purchase an expensive router plate that moves the router up and down on the surface of the table. Harvey makes an absolutely amazing fence for this table, but it wasn't in my budget, so I went with this Tay Tools Deluxe Fence. The quality is very good for the price. I did have to modify the fence a little bit. I had to drill two holes on the bottom of the fence, as the fence mounting holes did not match the Harvey's. Not a big deal, as it was an easy fix. Thanks for watching, and let me know if you have any questions in the comments below.